And in today's session, we will do animation. In this, we have animating doors and windows, and animating water, and character animation. So let's move with the software. Here we have the interface of 3ds Max. Click on the standard primitives. Here we have the doors and windows. Go to the door. On here a snap tool. Go to the top view and make a pivot door. And the sliding. And bifold. So here we have the all three doors. If I go to the modify list, here we have the parameters. As we see these parameters in modeling part, depth, double door, flip. If you want to flip the doors, here we have the open option of these doors. Double. And we can animate this by on this auto key or a set key. Press here auto key and put on 0 of key and on 20. I put here a like 70%, then put a key. If I slide this on this timeline, you can see the animation on this door. Again on 40, I press here 100%. Off the auto key. Play it from here. Again on the auto key. And press here 0. See the animation in the door. As we do animation in this bifold door, we can do animation in this sliding door. This is the slide door. Again, we make this slide door. Go to the perspective. Increase the height. This is the slide door. On the auto key, put here a key. We can see the animation on both doors. Here we have the pivot door. Press here key on 0. On 20. Pivot door is to be open on 180 degrees. These are the doors. Press here and go to the windows. Again, we have here a windows. Casement window. On this snap tool, then make the fixed window. Increase the height so we can see the animation in the viewport. You can animate this from here, open and close, put here a key on timeline, on 0, on 30. As on fixed window. On fixed window, we do not have the option of opening. So, we take another window, pivoted. Go to the modify list. Here we have the open option. Set a key on 0, around 30, plus here are 50, around 60, but here are 100. You can see the animation on all the doors and windows. So in this we have discussed the doors and windows, how we can animate, and our second one is animating water. Reset the max. Here we have a model. We have a pool model. I want to fill here a water and then animate the water. For this, I take a plane, the top view, sign with the grid, just in the z axis according to the model, increase the segments, here are 30, put on this water material. Put a color on the water, so we can see in this render. Now we can see that there is a water in the pool. Then put a noise from the modify list. Increase the strength. The z axis, on the auto key and set a key on 0 frame. Increase the scale on 30th frame, then set a key. Seed, put a key on 60, increase the scale and the seed. Then put a frame on 80. Of this auto key. Delete this key. With the noise, we can animate the water. You see the render. Increase the timeline. And I move these frames. Get the more smooth effect in the water, increase the segments in the plane, because this noise modifier work on the segments. If I decrease these segments, there is no look of water. There is no ripple. Take here a 50, and we can see in the viewport we have a smooth effect of water. With the noise modifier, we can animate the water. And our third one is character animation. Set the max. Here we have the model. So, before animating this character, we see the poses. First, we make the contact pose, then the pass pose, then contact pose, this down pose and this up pose. We make after this contact pose. This is the contact pose. The feet are contact with this surface, and the down pose the whole body weight on this right leg and the pass pose on this leg, then the up pose. You can see there is a left leg and then contact pose. So, here in this character we have a contact pose. These are the controllers of this model. Give the feel of jumping. These are the leg controllers. Go to the side view. Select these three controllers and on the auto key and put a key on 0 frame. Move the frame on 12 or on any key. Move this in X axis, put a key, select this leg controller, and rotate this. Set the key, first we are making this pass pose. So, this image, set the keys, on 24. Again, make a contact pose. see the arcs on the trajectory from here. See this contact pose, how is the position of this character in this image? Then the pass pose. When we are making this pass pose, our left leg passing this leg, as we see here. Increase the timeline. We see on this leg here, our leg is sliding on this frame. So we tweak this from the editor, curve editor. move the body of the character the x axis. Then the left leg to make the contact pose. Can see the image, how's the character in the this position. We see in this viewport there is a sliding of this leg, this frame on 47, 46 and this on 59. So, select this controller and move this frame on the same frames. Rotate this left leg. Go to the perspective view and see the walk. And after making this frames, so we select the controller and right click, go to the curve editor. Here we have the curves of the frames which we have put on timeline. This shows the pose in x axis and position in y axis and the z axis. We can adjust these curves from here. Whatever change we make in this curve editor is to be placed on animation. If you want a rigid, press shift. This gives us a rigid feel. Minimize this window and see here. There is a jerk feel on this frame, like here. We can smooth our animation from the curve editor. Select this right leg controller, open the curve editor, again play with the curves. Our right leg is sliding here. I delete here a key from the curve editor and adjust this curve. after making the contact pose and the pass pose, we make here in between we make a down pose, and in this pass pose and contact pose we make a up pose. Then see our image. Now we want to make this pose. Adjust this feet. And here a pose. We see here the most pose is here. This pose. This is how we animate the characters. Putting the keys on timeline. Giving a more time, we get output like this. So, this is an animation, and this character animation, we animate the character. and this is the end of 3ds Max.